we come from there and we just, it's a sea of people. It was mad. The tunnel was blocked because like all the fans were already, they were already there and they blocked it, and you could see them, you can hear them banging on the coach, and we're thinking, oh my gosh, this is gonna be crazy. They've got these like flares and that. Literally, it's dark, total darkness, but you just see flares and you just see, just hear shouting. There's like a thing and it just goes boom. Yeah, that was something I've never experienced before. Imagine being in the Champions League. They're picking sides, they're crossing the line. I stick to the truth, I'm one of a kind. Gave it a God and follow his signs. Now all of a sudden I'm stuck in my prime. I'm wishing them well, I threw them a dime. They stuck in the shell, they're drowning with time. You see the game, we still undefined. If they're coming at us, they better rewind. Well, I was born in Canada, and then just before I was one, moved to England. Then from year 11, when I was 16, moved to Cobham, Chelsea. Those are like probably the funnest times. We had good players, and like it's gonna sound so like, you know, whatever, but like we knew we were good. Like we knew we were a good team. We knew we had good players. We had a good manager. So we were like, every game was just like, yeah, let's just go win it. Like thinking back on it now, like I wouldn't say we took it for granted, but I don't think we realized how good those times actually were at the time. But now we're looking back on it, we're like, wow, that those were really, really good. Everyone just worked so well together. We just had like this crazy, crazy team. Tammy, obviously, Dom Solanke, Ola Aina, Jeremy Boga, Mason Mount, Trevor, Chaloba, Andreas Christensen, Loftus-Cheek. We just had so many players. In academy or in Chelsea, obviously, like all the coaches, they know you from when you were young, and it's kind of like developing players. So everyone's more like, it's kind of like, oh, they put an arm around you. But then it's like, suddenly you're going into men's football. It's like, listen, if you're not playing, if you're not doing the things you have to do, if you're not recovering right, if you're not doing the things you have to do to get better, you're just not going to play. I went to Brighton. At this point, they were in the Championship, top of the league. That was a good 6 months, a good kind of toe dipper into professional football. And then the next year was Hull City, and that was like my first full year on loan, way up in Hull, like far. I didn't realize how far it was, but it was far away. And then the next year was Derby County. Second best loan behind Milan. Second best loan. I was there with Mason. Mason was there, so obviously I knew Mason from years back. Yeah, that was the second year, full year of professional football. And you know, I think that year I played 50 something games. And then the Championship is hard. Every game, you know, you're coming off and you're absolutely finished. And obviously the next year I was in Chelsea's team.
So here we go, Chelsea versus Sheffield United. Fikayo Tomori makes his first start for the Blues.
My first start was Sheffield United at Stamford Bridge. I remember like, as the game was going on, I was thinking, I'm feeling pretty good. Like, I'm not like thinking, what is going on here? I was thinking, yeah, I'm feeling pretty good. Obviously, I've trained with the team, so I knew the players. Like, I knew, okay, if I'm in trouble, just give it to Jorginho kind of thing. I'd be like, yeah, Georgie, take it. Going home, I thought like, I remember I hadn't watched Match of the Day in ages. I remember, so I have to go home and watch Match of the Day just to see myself on Match of the Day. So yeah, that was nice.
Oh, wonderful hit from Tomori. What a way to score his first goal for Chelsea.
That game, I remember. I remember when I scored that, I just didn't know what to do. Because I've said this story before, but I remember the day before in training, we're doing a shooting drill. And a ball came out to me just like that. And I skied it so high. And Willie Caballero was like, he was making fun of me. He's like, what is that? So as the ball's coming out to me, I'm thinking, I can't take a touch, because if I take a touch, I'm going to have no options. But I thought, I can't really cross it because it's that I'm central. I thought, I'm going to have to shoot. But I just side-footed it. I didn't lace it. I just side-footed it. I thought, I'm just going to get my foot behind it. If the keeper catches it, he catches it. And it just went off my foot, went in. And after that, I just started running. Like, I just didn't know what to do. I was just running. Obviously, Tammy scored two. So I remember, like, we was 3-0 up at half-time. I remember me and Tammy were sitting next to each other. And like, the man, so obviously everyone's like, Fick, what a goal kind of thing. And I was like, yeah, keep going, whatever. Manager talks. And then me and Tammy kind of look at each other, kind of like, this is happening, kind of thing, like, yeah, we both scored. And then he must have said something to me like, oh, I've been running all day, I'm so tired. I was like, what do you mean you're tired? You're on two goals, mate. One more, you got a hat trick in the Prem. I was like, nah, you have to keep going. And he scored his hat trick. I remember I was like, and you were telling me you was tired, kind of thing. And then after that, and then Mason scored after. And then I remember that was like, that was probably the moment where we really thought, right, like, we're actually here, boys. Like, we actually did it. That was probably the best day at Chelsea, like in the first team, 100%. Playing in the Champions League, you know, everything's just going really well. Then 2020 hits, obviously COVID hits. Then it's just like everything, the season gets broken up and obviously things happen and then I just wasn't playing as much. I think it kind of helped build like a fire in me kind of thing to be like, okay, well, this is how it feels like when you're not playing. That was like, again, a time where I was like, okay, cool. This happened in 2020, got a bit nut off. Remember what, you know, how it felt, what you need to do, etc., etc. 2021, build on it, and then yeah, 2021, it's a good year. It was actually that summer in the 2020. So at that point, that was the first time I ever spoke to Maldini, and I remember I was on Zoom. He came up on the screen, and I was just like, we were speaking, whatever. And I was surprised he spoke English. So when he spoke English, I was thinking, oh, speaking English. We spoke for a bit. And then after, I kind of sat there and thought, I just had a conversation with Maldini. And in my head, I was thinking, well, even if I don't go to Milan, I can say I've spoken to Maldini, kind of thing. And he said, how do you feel like coming to Milan? But it was a few days before, but I'd already been like, I said, I'd already like, not agreed, but I'd been like, okay, if I go on loan, I'm coming to you, kind of thing, to another team. Obviously, then it didn't happen, so then I stayed an extra 6 months at Chelsea. But then at that point, I thought, rah, AC Milan? Whoa. That sounds decent, you know? But I thought, okay, but I thought, I just didn't feel ready for that yet, to be honest. I just didn't feel, I feel like the way my head was, I don't think I was ready to really, you know, move countries at that point. And then it got to around December times, and the transfer window was coming up again. You know, me and my agent were discussing things. He's like, well, what about Milan? I was like, yeah. I was like, yeah. My head was ready here. I was kind of like, yeah, I'm going to be playing for Milan. I'm going to go on loan 6 months. But I didn't tell anyone because I didn't really want to jinx it. But actually, like, I just thought, yeah, I'm probably going to be playing in Milan. And it was weird as well. Like, I remember when I first signed, and like they gave me a bag with like a tracksuit in it, and it had a Milan badge on it, and I was like, wait, am I playing for AC Milan? Kind of thing, like, even my dad was like, yeah, you play for AC Milan. And that was another point where I thought, like, have I, like, is this, like, am I here? Like, am I a footballer, kind of thing? Like, am I here? Like, is this happening? I was there with my agent, actually, so my agent was there. I remember we walked in, and we're just seeing Champions League, bang, 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 bang. Seeing Ballon d'Ors, bang, 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 bang. Seeing, like, players, seeing Kaká, you're seeing Zlatan, you're seeing Maldini, you're seeing Baresi, you're seeing Shevchenko, you're seeing this, you're seeing this. You just walk around just thinking, yeah, this is like a proper, proper, proper club. Like, you're just thinking, rah. And I hadn't even been to the San Siro yet. So when I first got there, obviously there was COVID, so it was a bit different. But even the first time I walked in, it's just like, just come up the stairs and it's just like, the stadium just goes boom. And you just look around, it's like, rah, this is just so big. And then the first time, like, the stadiums were full. I remember the first time I really, really felt it was the first Champions League game. So obviously we qualified for the Champions League, first time in a while. So we played Atletico Madrid, and that noise, I'd never heard anything like it. Like, you know, the song comes on, and then all the fans goes, the job! I remember that, I was like, oh my gosh. I've never heard of this, never heard this before. They're so passionate about everything. I remember Tony Ruger came up to me, he goes, you went to AC Milan? I was like, I don't know, kind of thing. He's like, oh, you see, if you get that chance, you have to go. Like, obviously, he played in Rome. So he's like, oh, you're playing in Italy. Like, if you do well, they're going to love you. Then Kovacic, he played in Inter. So he's telling me, oh yeah, Milan, great city, great fans, the San Siro, da 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 da. Then at this point, Thiago Silva didn't really speak English. But he was like, oh, AC? He's like, oh, you go to Milan? He was like, He was like, yeah. And then Emerson, like, obviously so many people were playing in Serie A, so Emerson, Jorginho, he was talking about Napoli, so he's like, oh yeah, when you play against Napoli. So he's saying like, yeah, they're properly, like, they're on it there, it's crazy. So like, and I kind of got a feel for it at that point, but then actually being here is totally different. But they all said like, yeah, you're gonna enjoy it, you're gonna love it. And I mean, they weren't wrong, so.
It's Milan versus Atalanta at the San Siro. AC Milan with the opportunity to seal the title today.
So at this point, it was like, if we won and Inter lost, we could have won the title that day. Me as a player, I could feel it. I could feel like, today, it could actually happen today. Stadium was crazy. Second half, you could feel like, you can feel everyone's like, we need to score, we need a goal, come on boys. And then Rafa scored, scored the goal. And like the whole stadium it just went mad. Even us as players, we look at each other, we're like, come on. And then Teo scores that crazy goal. Takes all, just dribbles all the way up pitch, scores. As we celebrate and all that stuff, and when I'm walking back, I was out of breath from celebrating, shouting. I was because the energy was just so you could, it's you could almost feel it in the state. It was and then I remember my friends after, we didn't win it that day, but I remember my friends yeah, that is the best stadium atmosphere I've ever been in. Even though you haven't won the title, but it felt like, my friend was like, it feels like you won the title. Obviously we haven't won the game, but he's like, you feel like you won it. But now we have the last game, we haven't won it yet, but you can win it away. My friends never really came to away games, so they came to this one, obviously. But and I remember seeing Sassuolo games and the stands, it wasn't full. But when we got there, literally, so they had 1, 2, 3, 4 stands. They had this stand with their ultra supporters. The rest of the stadium was just Milan. Milan fans have crashed the Sassuolo website. People are trying to pay thousands and thousands, thousands for tickets. I was thinking, whew. Yeah, that first half, Sassuolo, we just, even in change room before, everyone's like, yeah, this is it, boys, this is it. And we just score one, bang, two, bang. When Kessie scored that third goal, I don't think I've ever been that happy. I remember I was thinking, 45 minutes and it's finished. I remember a fan, he grabbed me, by here, here. He was like, Vic, I can't tell you how much this means to us. Thank you so much. I was like, rah. And he said it to me in English. I was like, rah. He's like, thank you so much. It means so much to us. You don't understand. I was like, rah. I remember just looking outside and there were just so many fans. And it took us 5.5 hours to go 5 kilometers because there were just so many fans and it was actual madness. And we got to the Duomo and you could not see any, it was just a sea of people. You could just feel the way the fans feel about the team, and then how they feel about us as players. For me personally, that was probably the biggest happiness, joy, because it was just I'm just here playing football, but you lot are properly supporting us, and the whole season you were with us and supported us, and they definitely helped us to win it for sure. It's such a different feeling. It's so difficult to describe unless you're actually in it or if you've lived it, because it's just out of this world. Need a triple.